hours, multiple same-day care options, and many convenient locations.
Dr. Hoffmeister, thanks for being with us today. Find a doctor who's right for you by visiting freightert.com/doctors.
Hi, I'm Mike Ansey from Ansey & Associates. We're passionate about continuing on our mission to help more Wisconsin businesses create more success. If you have any questions about our insurance products or just want a second opinion about your insurance or employee benefits, I invite you to check out ansey.com, or better yet, give us a call at Ansey & Associates. And let's have a conversation about your business and how we can help you secure, protect, and grow your version of the American dream.
It's WTMJ's Debbie Lozaga for Comfort Awnings. You've heard me talk about the wonderful new retractable awning the team at Comfort Awnings installed at my home. Now I can have all the cookouts and get-togethers in my backyard with some extra shade and relaxation for my guests. Comfort Awnings is a local family-owned company in Burlington that provides expert installation in southeast Wisconsin and northern Illinois. Right now, you'll receive $250 off with the purchase of any awning or screen until April 14th. Call 414-AWNINGS or visit comfortawnings.com.
The place you want to go, Lynch McGuanago.
Nobody sells for less than Lynch.
Trusted, relevant, locally owned, locally programmed. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ Milwaukee.
It's 11 o'clock. I'm Greg Matzik. This is Wisconsin's Midday News for Thursday, April 4th. Your top story, a missing boy's caretaker back in court.
I'm Jessica Tai. More messy weather in Wisconsin and across the country.
Some early snow showers today. It'll eventually be more of a rain-snow mix. Cloudy and breezy with a high of 41. Slight chance of a rain-snow mix tonight with a low of 33. Decreasing clouds on Friday. We'll see a peak of the sun with a high of 43. It's 35 degrees in Milwaukee. At 11:01 from the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, the boyfriend of missing Elijah Vu's mother in court today for a preliminary hearing. Jesse Vang, along with Vu's mother, Katrina Bauer, have both been charged with child neglect but are still not charged in Vu's disappearance. Bauer will be back in court April 26th. Vu has now been missing since February 20th.
A longtime Wisconsin politician and former Wisconsin congressman may attempt to return to Washington.
Peter Barca is the current Wisconsin Secretary of Revenue. He was a U.S. congressman from 1993 to 1995 and tells me he could run for the seat again.
Well, I've not made a decision on that. It's something I've looked at, and I've had quite a bit of encouragement. So, you know, our pattern has been to work across the aisle and try and get things done, and so that's why I'm at least looking at it.
Brian Stile currently holds the seat and is running for re-election. Peter Barca has already announced he's leaving his revenue position. John Merkier, WTMJ News.
While snow and rain has created a wet mess across Wisconsin this week, other storm systems have caused problems across a giant stretch of the United States.
It's been a stormy couple of days across a huge section of the country. At least 28 tornadoes reported across 9 states, including in Kentucky, where a person was killed. In Georgia, a twister packing winds of 150 miles an hour hit outside Atlanta. In the Northeast, outside Philadelphia, a woman was killed when a tree crushed her car in high winds and torrential rain that extended into the New York tri-state area. Hundreds of thousands are without power up and down the East Coast, and in Portland, Maine, nearly a foot of snow has fallen with high winds reducing visibility. Folks being told to stay off the roads. Derek Dennis, ABC News.
Meanwhile, an overflow alert remains in effect this morning from the Milwaukee Metropolitan Sewerage District. The deep tunnel is now at 77% capacity. The Jones Island Reclamation Facility is at 83%, and the Northwest Side Deep Tunnel is almost at full capacity now. MMSD recommends limiting water use to prevent the risk of basement backups and sewer overflows. That means not washing dishes or your laundry and taking shorter showers.
No Brewers game today, but a lot going on outside the stadium despite the weather. Brewers, along with WTMJ, collecting items for the Wisconsin Humane Society. WTMJ's Debbie Lozaga is there at Hellfair Field.
We're teaming up with the Brewers Community Foundation to collect pet supplies for the Wisconsin Humane Society. I spoke with Wisconsin Humane Society's Stacy Oatman about what exactly they are looking for by way of donations.
Items such as those soft dog treats that they love to have so much, potty pads, peanut butter, unscented baby wipes we use a lot in the shelters, dog toys, any kind of food, and cat litter.
So lots of fun. Come on out. I've already met one dog. His name was Norman. He was absolutely adorable.
We'll check in with Deb to see how things are going coming up at about 11:25. Time for news about your money, the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. A good start to the markets, with the Dow currently up about 187 points at 39,314. The NASDAQ up about 167 points at 16,445. And the S&P 500 up about 40 points today at 5,251. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Check out AnnexWealth.com. Click on the Get Started button today.
Sports, traffic, and weather next. Saudi Unlimited WTMJ News Time is 11:04.
This is Matt Meitner, owner of Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Do you find yourself talking to your dog but feel like she's not listening to you?
Bella, sit!
Are you constantly repeating yourself but she's not following your directions?
Sit! Sit!
Frustrating, isn't it? At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we want to help you have a happy, confident, and obedient dog. And we also want to make the training process an enjoyable and worthwhile experience. Contact Sit Means Sit today to schedule a free consultation so we can create a customized training program so you are able to have the dog you want and deserve.
Sit Means Sit Dog Training.
Sorry, we don't train husbands, wives, or kids.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. If you're like me, my home has become a happy place. It's happier now thanks to CertaPro Painters. They are simply the best in the business. They will take care of the scuffs, the faded colors. They'll make your home a new home, inside or outside. They did the work at our house. It was quick, easy, and so, so affordable. Their estimates are always easy. You get a quote right away. It's simply the best in the business. Schedule your free estimate online at CertaPro.com. That's Certa with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
Burkhart Sporting Goods has a great reputation for producing custom team apparel. We're total team outfitters and we can handle the biggest jobs. Our success in custom team apparel led us into group and corporate apparel. Plus, we have a full selection of promotional products for employee gifts, special events, you name it. And we've made it easy for our customers to firm up their orders. The group sale web stores that we build for our customers are a simple way of gathering all the information you need. They're easy to work, easy to understand, and with them, you'll have access to nearly limitless options. We've seen that most times we're better priced than our competition on the same high-quality apparel choices that the other guys offer, plus Nike and Under Armour choices that the other guys can't get. And we offer a huge brand selection from Yeti, North Face, and Carhartt, too. This is Brian Burkhart. For team, group, or corporate custom outfitting and promotional products, it's going to be really hard to beat our prices, selection, and ease of buying for any size budget and every size company. And that's why we always say,
you can't beat Burkhart.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. Sports Desk. It's a day off for the Brewers, who welcome in the Seattle Mariners for a three-game weekend series beginning Friday night. Milwaukee 4-1 to begin the season. The Oakland A's are planning to move to Sacramento for the 2025 through 27 seasons, with an option to play there as well in 2028. The A's continue to explore a permanent home in Las Vegas. And with six games left on the regular season schedule, the Bucks own a 1.5-game lead over the Cavaliers for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race. Bucks face the Toronto Raptors on Friday.
Taking a look at the roads with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. I do want to let you know about one crash that is out on the system right now. I-43 at North Avenue, the right shoulder is blocked due to a crash. And just be careful out there. Take it slow. It is wet. I'm taking a peek at the I-43 camera at Silver Spring right now, and it's just rain droplets on the camera. It's that kind of day today.
Traffic is sponsored by Annex Wealth Management. It's time to know the difference, and Annex Wealth Management is ready to help with investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning as a fee-only fiduciary partner. AnnexWealth.com. Click the Get Started button.
Well, this holding pattern of rain and clouds and snow, we're in it. Again, chance of early snow showers today. You've likely already seen it. Overnight, you'll see some rain-snow mix around the area. We'll bottom out at about 33 degrees. Decreasing clouds tomorrow, might see some sun with a high of 43. A definite sunny day on Saturday with a high of 50 inland, 46 near the lake. It's 36 degrees in Milwaukee at 11:08.
Live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios in downtown Milwaukee, it's Wisconsin's Midday News, making stories come to life. Now, here are your hosts, Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai.
So I get all these emails from the National Weather Service to different areas, different counties across the state. And for the last 3 days, I have seen more flood watch and flood warnings continuing really for the next several days. And this is because of high water levels in rivers and lakes. Like, we live near the Fox River. We can see it from a part of our house.
So you can tell it's high.
I've never been able to see more of it
really
than I have today.
Really? Never?
And how long have you guys lived there?
About 7 years. So it's kind of off in the distance in our backyard, but we can see it. But definitely more visible today than usual.
It has just been so wet for so many days. Going outside, taking the dog out this morning before work. Well, number one, downtown Milwaukee, it was actually snowing just a little bit this morning. But it was still just everything is so soggy. I go out there, I'm in like tennis shoes, and I come back in and you got wet toes. So you have to change the socks. I think everybody's just ready for some dry weather.
No doubt about that. Get some chili on the stove today. Why not?
That sounds good.
It's a good kind of a comfort food today.
And now it's time for three big things on Wisconsin's Midday News.
Number one, if you have grand plans for viewing Monday's total eclipse, you might want to check the forecast first.
Some of the 22 states included in the path of totality from Texas to Maine could have cloud cover or even snow. The sky's the last piece of the puzzle for millions flocking to areas to watch when the moon blocks the sun. Michelle Franzen, ABC News.
Wisconsin is not in the path of totality, but this is expected to be the biggest solar eclipse in the state in 70 years. That's a long time. Weather permitting, we're looking at up to 90% blockage in Wisconsin with a peak around 2 p.m. Monday.
Well, the largest producer of fresh eggs in the United States finds bird flu in chickens at plants in Texas and Michigan. As a result, egg production halted at the Cal-Maine plant in Texas. Nearly 2 million chickens casualties of the infection. Company said there is no known bird flu risk associated with the eggs that are currently in the market. No eggs have been recalled. That's good news. Some cattle have also been affected. In fact, a dairy worker in Texas is believed to have been infected by one of the impacted animals, triggering some farm closures and now increased attention by the CDC.
It can be highly contagious. It evolves rapidly, just like our flu that circulates in our populations. There have been some instances of people getting infected with bird flu, but typically it's people who work with poultry, work with animals.
And ABC's Sony Salzman.
Are free blue check marks back? Have you checked your X account?
Never had
formerly
one,
formerly known as Twitter.
Yeah, I don't know. I never had one.
You never had one. I never had one either. On X, I have them on Facebook. I didn't really care whether I had them or not. I felt like people who were checking in on me knew. I think if you had a lot of spoofs out there, then you would be worried about it. But it wasn't something I cared about. A lot of people did though. When their blue check marks went away, they were not happy. So the coveted verification symbol returned to certain X accounts, with the criteria appearing to be that accounts must have more than 2,500 verified subscribers. According to a statement from Elon Musk, all accounts with more than 2,500 verified subscribers will get premium features for free. Premium plus benefits will be given to accounts with more than 5,000 verified subscribers. In April of 2023, Musk removed all blue check marks, forcing subscribers to sign up and pay for Twitter Blue. So that was why a lot of people just were not happy. They're like, hey, you gave it to us before. We didn't have to pay anything. Now you're going to take it away if we don't pay? People didn't like that.
Yeah, so pre-Elon Musk, when you were on Twitter, if my name or your name just got a blue check mark next to it, that's how you knew it was officially us. It was us. Nobody pretending to be us or some sort of spot or burner account. Well, then Elon gets in there, changes the name of the company, number one, and then takes the blue checkmark thing and says it's a paid-for thing only, and that was kind of a firestorm. Now, you know, who knows? You've got random bots, AI-generated X accounts that have blue checkmarks next to it, and you just don't know what to believe is to be real.
I'm curious as to how many of our listeners actually use X, formerly Twitter. I have noticed that the numbers have certainly gone down over the years. A lot of people just weren't happy with the changes. But then some people love it, and it's never going to go away. Have you noticed that at all with the number? I know my Facebook numbers have gone up. My Twitter numbers have gone down a little bit with all the changes.
Now, that's interesting. Might have been pretty consistent, I guess, overall. I don't look at Facebook followers or subscribers. Twitter, I guess it's more front and center. I guess I just noticed that more.
Yeah.
But it's been pretty consistent,
all right,
I think, over the years.
Well, let us know, listeners. Yeah. Hey, if you like X, let us know. We'd love to find out.
Always looking for ways to communicate with you. Coming up next, a very interesting story. If you are in need of a kidney and there is no obvious donor available, might an animal be able to help you? It's 1114 on WTMJ.
Creative Planning presents Rethink Your Money with John Hagenson, Saturday afternoon at 1. At Creative Planning, we custom tailor your portfolio to help you achieve your ideal financial future. You'll see how our wealth managers work with in-house CPAs and attorneys to ensure your money is working as hard as it can for you. why not give your wealth a second look? Visit creativeplanning.com. That's creativeplanning.com.
Oh, with all the rain and all the snow and all the mess, boy, the dog parks are an absolute mess right now. That's why it's a great day to take your dog to the Hounds and Tap in Menominee Falls. 12,000 square feet. They've got a dog park that is mud-free. They've got turf. They've got indoor facilities, outdoor facilities as well. But again, turf on the ground means you're not washing paws when the dog gets home. The Hounds and Tap in Menominee Falls, right off Silver Spring. It is a great place to hang out, with or without your dog, for that matter. Grab a drink at the tavern. You can meet some others while your pup enjoys the dog park, that mud-free dog park. Heaters as well. It's a fun and happy environment. Doggy daycare, doggy boarding, doggy grooming services, all right there in one location, 12,000 square feet. Really is a wonderful place to hang out. Food trucks arriving when the weather's good. Fundraisers every Sunday is a family day, so bring the kids out as well. And join the folks at the Hounds and Tap. Check out their Facebook page. See all the pictures of happy pups on display as they're enjoying their daycare day at the Hounds and Tap. It's in Menominee Falls. Online, it's thehoundsandtap.com.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. When you're ready to get out and prep your yard for spring, we get you the right products at the right prices. Like all-new Estate Premium 4-in-1 Lawn Treatment, $59.99, with both pre- and post-emergent crabgrass killer in one application. 36-pound bags of Estate Weed and Feed, only $34.99. And 20-pound bags of Bio-Advanced Grub Killer Plus, $29.99 after sale and mail-in rebate. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
David Nason, host of the Fix It Show, here with my friend Chris Mancuso, owner of Accurate Basement Repair. Chris, what are some signs of basement problems that need to be addressed?
Hey, David, that's a great question. I would say wall cracks, leaning walls, dark or maybe some discolored stains across the walls. Those are really important things to look at.
As a home inspector, I see this often. Don't wait to call the experts I recommend at Accurate Basement Repair today for your free assessment.
They're not just good, they're accurate.
Wintry mixed pattern today with showers and some snow all mixed in. Cloudy and breezy with a high of 41. A slight chance of that continuing tonight with a low of 33. Clouds should be on the decrease tomorrow with a high of 43. Then we get back to sunny conditions on Saturday with a high of 50 degrees inland, 46 if you're closer to the lake. 36 degrees in Milwaukee, approaching 11:17. Well, every once in a while I read a story and then I go back to the top of the publication to see if I'm reading it out of the Onion. This would be one of those cases. A happy homecoming this week for a patient at the center of a pioneering transplant operation. ABC's Jim Ryan here to give us in all the details. I did not think I'd get to the point in my life, Jim, where we're talking about a man who has a new lease on life because of a pig kidney.
Yeah, but that is the case now. His name is Richard Sleeman. He has gone home a week after this groundbreaking surgery. 62 years old. He has been suffering end-stage kidney failure. He's been on dialysis for years. Well, that may be in the past now for him after this groundbreaking surgery. He had a modified pig kidney transplanted into his body, and by all reckoning right now, Greg, it appears to be holding.
And you say modified. What did they have to do to the pig kidney to make it work in the human, Rick?
They used technology to take out some of the harmful pig genes that were there, Jessica, and then to add some human genes to improve the compatibility of that kidney with Sleeman's body to make sure there's no risk of infection or to reduce the risk of rejection. And in fact, right after this was transplanted into his body, Sleeman was showing signs of rejection. Doctors went in, they were able to stop that, and now, by all accounts here, at least according to his surgeons, everything is working well, Jessica. So, I mean, every day that goes by is a good day for him. He was at end stage. He knew that that this was his last hope. His doctors came to him and said, you want to try this? You're kind of a guinea pig in this case. He said he would do it, and he says he feels great.
Hey, Jim, I'm not a nephrologist, nor do I play one on the radio, but when it comes to organ transplants, I'm always thinking about everything, right? The size of the organ, the compatibility, the blood type. Does all of that come into play here?
Oh, absolutely it does. You know, at the very center of the whole thing, of course, I mean, pig kidneys are pretty compatible with the human body. Lots of organs from pigs are compatible with human. I mean, our anatomy is fairly similar. And so, you know, in size and in shape and the rest of it, this thing appeared to be a perfect match for Slim. And of course, without this modification that was done, this genetic modification, which is only available now, there was no hope that this was going to work either.
What do you think about all this when it comes to the future?
Well, it's fantastic. And his doctors, Slayman's doctors, say that this is offers hope to the 100,000 or so kidney patients on dialysis now who are desperately waiting for a donated kidney. It's a simple matter of math, Jessica. Too many people on the waiting list, too few organ donors to shore up the, you know, that number to make up the deficit. So if we can, you know, raise pigs for their organs and can modify them so that they work, I mean, that's going to take out a lot of that deficit. It's going to be give a lot more hope to a lot more patients.
Yeah, without a doubt. Did they test I'm trying to remember a while ago, did they test a pig kidney in a dead body before this or somebody who was brain dead?
Well, they've been doing that for some time. I mean, it doesn't matter if let's say that you signed your driver's license as an organ donor. Okay, and for whatever reason you die, well, they can keep the body alive or keep the physical functions going even if you're brain dead. And sometimes a pig kidney is used to accomplish that until your organs can be harvested for transplants. Kind of morbid, I suppose, but it's a life-saving thing. I mean, when my dad died, he was 89 years old, but he was an organ donor, and his organs and skin and corneas and all the rest went into five or six other people. I mean, it's an amazing thing that can be done. But as long as that it's fairly close after death, or if the body can be maintained, if function can be maintained, at least physically, then that's how this has been used in the past. This is completely different because a kidney that had been modified genetically has been put into a living recipient, and the living recipient now obviously is cured of diabetes and says he feels good.
Just a fascinating story. A genetically edited pig kidney is giving 62-year-old Rick Slayman a new lease on life. ABC's Jim Ryan. We'll check in again soon. Jim, thank you.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks,
yeah,
Jim.
Fascinating story. Hey, coming up next, the Brewers Community Foundation and WTMJ are teaming up on the team's first Drive for Charity event. It's happening right now at Health Fair Field. Debbie Lozga is out there. It's a pet supplies drive. We'll check in with Deb to see how it's going and the hours. If you want to stop by, drop anything off. They'd love to have you out there at Health Fair today. We'll check in with Deb coming up after this.
More of Wisconsin's Midday News on the way after this.
Some things are fine to buy from a vending machine, but despite what a certain national online company tells you, a car's not one of them.
Let's see. Cheese doodles, Mr. Nougat bar. Oh, here we go. Green four-door hatchback. Honey, we're gonna need some more quarters.
Sure, they make it seem convenient, but it won't be so convenient if you have a problem with the vehicle you buy. And if it's after 7 days, good luck. Adam member dealers also let you search online. And unlike those national companies, you get to see the vehicle in person and test drive it before you buy it. You also have the assurance that the vehicle's been thoroughly tested, and if any issue does come up, your local Adam member dealer is right here to service it and can also provide low financing and top dollar for your trade. Think about that before you take a chance with their so-called vending machine.
What? It's stuck! No! Oh, rats!
Start your search at ADAMM.com.
Each day, there's a sliver of time when you can almost breathe freely, and you feel better when you can, but you know that eventually that sliver of time closes, along with your nose. It puts a damper on your day every day. So you pop a pill or you take a spray to try to get that relief back, but it's always short-lived. And all the while in your efforts to give yourself relief, you may be making your nasal breathing problems worse. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula, and a simple in-office procedure from Advent called balloon sinuplasty could be the fast and convenient answer to your breathing triangle problems. Advent has been a leader in this procedure, which can be hard to find elsewhere. It's simple, there's little to no downtime, and it really can be life-changing.
Go to AdventKnows.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Breathe well with simple solutions. Breathe well with simple solutions. AdventKnows.com.
Results may vary.
Creative Planning presents Rethink Your Money with John Hagenson, Saturday afternoon at 1. At Creative Planning, we custom tailor your portfolio to help you achieve your ideal financial future. You'll see how our wealth managers work with in-house CPAs and attorneys to ensure your money is working as hard as it can for you. Why not give your wealth a second look? Visit creativeplanning.com. That's creativeplanning.com.
Wisconsin's Midday News on 620 WTMJ.
Well, the tour of Wisconsin continues on Top Chef. I was watching this last night, and they were at a beautiful farm in Oconomowoc tasting all the tasty dishes made by the chef testants, including Dan Jacobs. We've got a person who was on the farm joining us coming up at 11:37. Rachel Bernard, she's a food critic for the Journal Sentinel. She was there. She was tasting everything on that 95-degree day in, I don't know, July or August, whenever they filmed it.
So much cheese.
So much cheese, if you watched the episode last night.
It looks so good, though. And if you're a cheese connoisseur, you definitely recognized some of those names. As they were putting the company's names up, I'm like, oh, yeah, I bought that Merlot cheese once, you know, at the Metro Market here.
Sure. Very fun episode. Rachel's going to be with us. She was live tasting food during the Top Chef taping this past summer. Joining us right now, wishing it were summer-like conditions, it's the Brewers Community Foundation and WTMJ partnering on the team's first Drive for Charity event of the season. It's a pet supplies drive benefiting the animals in need in the Wisconsin Humane Society. And Debbie Lozga has been there all morning. Deb, how are things going so far?
It's wet. It's very wet and cold, but we are making the best of it. That's right. We are here collecting pet supplies for the Wisconsin Humane Society, and I'm going to be here until about a little after noon, but they are staying here collecting until 3 p.m. today for any kind of pet supplies that you can bring, pet treats, toys, blankets, towels, potty pads, cat litter. Even they'll take dog food and peanut butter. The peanut butter has to not have any xylitol in it. That's a sweetener that's toxic to animals. But those, you should be able to find those without a problem at the grocery store. But even if you're not going to bring anything specific to donate, you can actually donate money. And if you donate at least $10, you're not only going to get a nice, fuzzy, warm feeling in your heart because you're doing something great. We also have goodie bags for people. So basically, with a $10, at least $10 donation or pet supplies, we have collectible Pat Murphy and Ricky Weeks pins. These are only found, they're only giving them out during the charity drives with the Brewers Community Foundation throughout the season. So these are collectibles. You can only get them through these things. Also, the first 250 fans who donate in person will be able to get two free tickets, loge level, and a Brewers hat, couple of baseball cards as well. And so, yeah, come on out. And you can donate as well as here today, and also they are actually collecting over the homestand against the Mariners. So we've got spots that people are going to be able to donate when you come in to the stadium, and you're going to do a good deed. And also you'll get those pins, at the very least the pins, but pins and possibly loge tickets as well. So as supplies last, as you might imagine. But, you know, it's been a lot of fun, cold, wet, but fun out here at Health Fair Field. It's been pretty great seeing all the people bringing their dogs by so I can give them a little bit of love from their car. So, oh, that's the other thing, by the way. You don't even have to get out of your car. You just drive through and drop it off. You can stay nice and toasty warm in your car, and we'll take care of it once you get there. So want to beat the 5 pallets and $5,600 donations from last year. I think we can do it.
It is a fantastic effort. The Brewers, 620 WTMJ, and the Wisconsin Humane Society teaming up, and you don't even have to get out of your car.
It's
thanks,
perfect.
Debbie.
Thanks, Deb. We'll check in again in the noon hour.
You got it.
It's 11:28 on WTMJ.
Now, about your house. Eric Brown is the president of Siding Unlimited, your contractor for new windows, roofing, siding, decks, and a whole lot more. He knows about your house. So what do you know, Eric?
Do you have new siding and now you just want to keep it looking great? There are a couple things that come to mind when maintaining a beautiful home exterior. The first is just a good old cleaning. We recommend that you use a hose or a very light setting on your pressure washer to spray the dust off your siding. Don't force the water onto the siding very hard because water could get behind the siding and cause damage. Your home may or may not have a weather barrier behind the siding, and using high pressure water could cause problems. Definitely clean your siding to keep it looking beautiful, but don't get crazy and wash it off the building. Another quick tip to avoid siding issues comes with our favorite summer activity, grilling out. As much fun as it is to try different grilling recipes, using the grill too close to the home could result in some unforeseen disasters. When you use your grill, make sure it is away from the home. I like to make sure it is at least 7 feet from the house. If you have vinyl siding, the results of the grill being too close can be obvious, melted siding. However, if you have siding that won't melt, the heat from the grill could cause issues with the siding's paint or radiate through the siding and cause issues with the insulation, wiring, plumbing, or anything else in the wall that the heat could disturb. When you get new siding that is going to last a lifetime, just a few house cleaning tips can go a long way in preserving your beautiful home. Oh yeah, and keep the weed whacker away from the siding too. That never ends well.
Eric and his crews at Siding Unlimited are your go-to contractor here for replacement windows, roofing, decks, and, of course, siding. They are the best, as acknowledged by the many rewards their suppliers have conferred upon them. Now, take the next step. Check them out at SidingUnlimited.com. Siding Unlimited, siding, and a whole lot more.
ABC News, I'm Michelle Franzen. The phone call between President Biden and Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu began this hour. That according to a source familiar with the call. It is the first time both leaders are talking since Israeli airstrikes killed seven aid workers in Gaza. ABC's Karen Travers has more.
We are told that the president today during that phone call will express his outrage and frustration over the death of those aid workers. But the thing that people will be looking for is whether something changes on what the administration is doing, whether there are any conditions attached to the assistance, military or other aid that the United States is sending to Israel, and if that causes Israel to change course.
A hearing set today for Idaho college murder suspect Brian Koberger. His attorneys are asking for a change of venue, claiming the jury pool is biased. Spring and winter storms clashing in the Northeast with heavy snow in New England and heavy rain in New York and mid-Atlantic states. This is ABC News.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News time is 11:31. The Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office confirms that a leg found near Warnemont Park in Cudahy is that of a human. A resident going for a walk in the park called 911 Tuesday evening after discovering the leg. Resident John Hemmer tells TMJ4 News he frequents the park and is in shock.
Unbelievable. My dog and I come here all the time to walk. I golf here at Warnemont all the time. I grew up here. It's really a shocking crime. I've never seen or heard of anything like this in Cudahy before, ever.
Authorities say they are investigating this as a death and not necessarily a homicide.
Wisconsin Department of Revenue Secretary Peter Barca is considering a run for U.S. Congress.
Brian Stile currently represents the 1st Congressional District. Former U.S. Congressman Peter Barca says it's time for a change.
The state of politics today, the polarization is so cancerous and harmful to people. I mean, you know, people were Americans and were Wisconsinites. Your political party is a vehicle to getting things done.
The November election is only 7 months away. Barca says he'll decide if he'll run in the next couple of weeks.
2-3 weeks, somewhere in there.
Barca has already announced his departure from the Department of Revenue. John Merkier, WTMJ News.
Meanwhile, Green Bay OBGYN Kristen Lyerly has announced her campaign for outgoing U.S. Congressman Mike Gallagher's seat this morning. Gallagher will step down from his position later this month. Lyerly will join WTMJ Spanning the State at 1:15 this afternoon.
Well, new stops coming for Milwaukee's streetcar.
The streetcar will begin L-line service 7 days a week this month, which includes making stops at the Couture High Rise. The Milwaukee Business Journal reports the public will be able to use the Couture's ground floor transit center, which will also serve bus rapid transit, on April 11th. Right now, at least 60 of the Couture's 322 apartments have reportedly been leased. Meanwhile, who will occupy the around 40,000 square feet of retail space on the building's first three floors is still unknown. Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
5 games into the season, a new Brewers manager, Pat Murphy, has led the team to a 4-1 record. Senior VP and general manager Matt Arnold tells Wisconsin's Morning News he appreciates the relationship he has with his new skipper.
I trust Murph in every way. I mean, we've worked together now for 9 years. I mean, we have a great relationship. We don't agree on things all the time, you know, and that's okay. I think that's a great partnership that we have.
The Brewers are off today before a weekend series against the Mariners. Arnold joins Brewers 360 every Thursday at 7:45 on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Sports, traffic, and weather are next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News time is 11:34.
Heart disease won't stop us. Diabetes won't slow us down. Allergies, high blood pressure, shoulder pain, cancer. Nothing will keep us from pushing Wisconsin ahead. Because with the Fraidert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, forward progress is what we stand for. That means always pushing and always innovating. With new technologies and breakthrough treatments that make life better, whether we're sick or well. It means providing more convenience and more ways to receive medical excellence for all your health needs, for big and small. It means being there for you. Our family, caring for yours. So let's keep raising the bar. Let's keep testing the limits of what medicine can do. Let's push ahead and make life here as great as it can be. Visit Fraidert.com to find out how.
Drivers who switch and save with Progressive could save hundreds, which could be life-changing. I mean, you could put that money towards that zero-turn lawnmower you've always wanted. And after using its edge-shaping technology to meticulously sculpt the face of the Mona Lisa into your grass, you'll become the undisputed king of Saturday morning lawn care, leaving your neighbor and sworn enemy Gary to question his place in the delicate neighborhood ecosystem. And it's all because you could save money switching at Progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Not available in all states.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile. And the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time. There's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Fleet Farm's got everything you need for everyday life. Brands from Carhartt to Milwaukee to Purina to Goodyear to Rapala to Levi's and a whole lot more. In-store or online, check out all the brands Fleet Farm carries to help make your everyday life better.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. No game for the Brewers today. Off to a 4-1 start, dropping yesterday's game to the Twins. The Mariners visit for a 3-game weekend series beginning Friday night. And with 6 games left on the regular season schedule, the Bucks own a game and a half lead over the Cavaliers for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race.
Roads with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. We do still have the crash. DOT is reporting we still have the crash at I-43 North at North Avenue. The right shoulder is blocked there due to a crash. Also, a couple of disabled vehicles on the system. And remember, it's wet out there, so take your time. I-43 southbound Brown Deer Road to downtown. That's a 3-minute delay right now. And it's a 1-minute delay, 894 westbound, the Mitchell Interchange to the Hale Interchange.
Kind of a rain-snow mix for the rest of the day. 33 your overnight low. There should be decreasing clouds tomorrow with a high of about 45 degrees. It's supposed to dry out here in the next couple of days as we get into the later part of the weekend and early next week with temperatures topping out in the low 50s. It's 36 degrees in Milwaukee at 11:37. Episode 3 of Top Chef is in the books. Our guy Dan Jacobs is still in it.
Yes, love that.
All things Wisconsin being showcased, including yesterday. If you saw it, there are a couple different challenges on Top Chef. It's how they do it, a quick fire challenge, which is more of a in-house kind of deal. And then they've got their elimination challenge where they're out and about, somewhere, doing something. And if you watched the episode yesterday, you saw some great sights of downtown Milwaukee and then this beautiful farm in Oconomowoc.
It was gorgeous, yes.
Stunning.
And I have to say, this was also a first, what they did for this competition. The Cheese Festival. They said they'd never done that on Top Chef before.
It was all things cheese being celebrated on Top Chef yesterday. And at the farm in Oconomowoc, as the chef testants were piecing together their items with cheese as the ingredient, the key, the star of the show, all these people started to populate and congregate at this farm.
Who are all these people coming to the farm for the cheese?
Including Rachel Bernhardt, who's a dining critic for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. Did you spot yourself on Top Chef last night?
Near the end of the episode, you can catch me for 2 seconds, completely overheated, full of cheese and ready to wrap the day. But it was a really fun time. Yeah.
Did you pause it? Did you rewind it?
I absolutely did. I did screen grab it. I've been sending it to friends. My star shining moment.
That is really cool. Now, one thing we noticed yesterday is that it was 95 degrees, and that was a part of the episode yesterday. So people are out there doing their thing. Did you give people a little slack with their dishes when it's 95 degrees?
Absolutely. I felt so bad for the chefs out there all day. I mean, it was 95 degrees, if not hotter. It was a blazing sun, beautiful day, gorgeous blue skies. But, you know, there was very little shade, and I was overheating just as a guest. I wasn't even cooking, so I can't imagine what they were feeling like and that pressure on top of it all.
Did you actually get a chance to talk to some of the chefs about their dishes, or was it kind of a quick grab the dish and move on and rink it?
It was, you know, it was pretty open. I was able to talk with some of the chefs. They explained their reasoning behind their dishes, how it kind of ties into the kind of foods they cook at home or at their own restaurants, and they were really open to talk. It was really exciting.
What was the deal with the croquettes? It was like 95% of the chef testants were making croquettes.
Don't ask me. I think they were saying, you know, croquettes are a little bit easier to cook for 100 people. This was the first time that they had cooked for 100 people in the competition. So, you know, they could make and prepare the balls before and then fry them up that day. So I think they all had kind of that ease for a large crowd going for them.
Did you have much experience or interaction with the judges, or are they kind of off on a separate sort of spot?
They were, you know, they were among the crowd most of the time, but they were, you know, we were told we could interact with them if we wanted to, but not while they were on camera. So I, you know, most people were very kind about that, and they didn't rush them. But I got a nice hello and a handshake near the end of the day from Kristen, the host and the new host. But they were really friendly, and they took their jobs very seriously.
I was going to say, I feel like Kristen from watching just really seems to be enjoying herself. Did you get that feel too?
Absolutely. I spoke with her a couple times as they were taping through here, and she felt so at home. She said, you know, she grew up just across the lake in Michigan near Grand Rapids, and you could really feel her sense of ease and her love of Milwaukee while she was here.
So what did they ask you to do? All the people who were in attendance who are not officially judging, like from the judge's standpoint, what were you asked to do while you were there?
So we were asked, we were each given a scorecard with all of the contestants' names, their dishes, a description of their dish, and then we would rank them from 1 to 10. We had about 2.5 to 3 hours to taste everything, and we could go, you know, only once, but go as freely as we would like to. So a lot of people were talking about their favorite dishes. Oh, you have to go try this one.
Yeah.
Or I didn't love this one. So it was kind of fun to chat with everyone there and kind of talk about our favorites as we went.
What about Chef Dan Jacobs? Did you give him an extra point just because he's local? He's our guy.
It's hard. Probably. But I will say, if I was being completely unbiased, he still did have one of my top three dishes.
It was, what, top three?
Yes,
nice.
Absolutely. I looked back at my scorecard and he, yeah, I think I gave him an 8 out of 10.
So what was your favorite?
Dan's was up there, but, you know, I did love, spoiler alert, I did love Michelle's dish.
Okay, and she won, right?
She did win the competition.
So she's the barbecue chef. She had like a mac and cheese kind of, oh, she had a collard green, didn't
yes,
she?
Yes, she did. She had like a potato dumpling with a collard green, a sag paneer, and her southern spin on that Indian recipe. So it was fantastic, so flavorful. Just really different from everyone else's, not a croquette. So
yeah, exactly.
I appreciate that.
I loved her too because she had that little scene in Whole Foods where she was like, sorry, everybody in Milwaukee, but there are no collard greens left in the store. So it was kind of a fun moment.
I love her personality. And she was whooping it up the whole time when she was there. Like, you would not be able to tell that she was overheating. She was making sure everybody had energy. And so we were really happy. If Dan didn't win, we were happy that Michelle did.
Rachel Bernard is the dining critic for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. I feel like you've stepped into this role at a great time to be a dining critic in the city of Milwaukee. And I don't know how far you expand beyond Milwaukee, but this seems to be sort of I don't even know if it's a renaissance, but a golden age of dining in this city.
Absolutely. We're getting more and more national attention, and rightfully so. You know, there are, you know, the New York Times and Bon Appetit have pointed out different restaurants. Eater just named Milwaukee one of the, you know, top three cities in America to visit, or in the world, I'm sorry.
Woo!
So, you know, it's not just us that know it.
Yeah.
Like, people are getting aware of Milwaukee's great restaurant scene.
That's so fantastic. So what was the favorite part for you? And you actually had to sign an NDA too, which I was a little bit surprised about. The more I think about it, maybe not. But I know a lot of the chefs who are involved had to do that, and the, some of the other people who have been involved. But just to eat cheese. You had to sign an NDA.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it was kind of a scary NDA too. So I haven't said anything to anyone until today about my experience there. You know, they don't want any spoilers to leak out. They don't want to share the winners or who gets sent home, and I completely understand that.
Did you also hear people talking about Wisconsin cheeses? Because I noticed last night as I was watching, there was Merlot cheese that I'm like, I've bought that numerous times. Yeah. I mean, did people talk about just the awesome cheese that we do have in our state?
They did. And what was great also about the episode, so many of the cheese makers were guests as well.
Yes.
So, you know, I saw it on screen, but I also was chatting with a lot of them throughout the day, and they seemed so excited and proud that their cheeses were showcased on the show by name and title too. And, you know, there were so many of them. If you saw them pop up on the screen, there's so many that we can be really proud of here.
That is very cool. What a cool opportunity for you too, Rachel. Thank you for sharing your experience with us.
Thank you for having me.
You bet. Rachel Byrne, our dining critic for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. Dr. Ben Weston, our weekly wellness check with the doc coming up after this. It's 11:45.
Welcome back to Ask Hassleless.
What makes Hassleless mattress different?
Aside from employee-free showrooms, free next-day delivery, and prices that are way too low?
Yeah, besides that.
Hassleless mattress is locally owned and managed by the same family.
So?
So, your money stays right here. And through Monday, you'll get a $200 credit towards a new Beautyrest, Sealy Posturepedic, and Serta Perfect Sleeper just for shopping local.
Thanks.
For what?
For being different.
Find a no-hassle, employee-free showroom near you at Hassleless.com.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkamp, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
And I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkamp leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Why are people saying "Hugh yeah" to Jackson Hewitt? Find out before it's too late. Hurry into Jackson Hewitt today.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry. Semper Fi.
SemperFiRoofing.com.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, "no appraisal required." When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, "no appraisal required," and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
A rain-snow mix throughout the rest of the day. Cloudy and breezy with a high of 41. Certainly won't feel like it, however. That chance of rain and snow is going to linger through tonight with a low of 33. Decreasing clouds, a chance of sun tomorrow with a high of 43. 36 degrees in Milwaukee at 11:48.
Doctor, doctor, give me the news. I got a bad case of loving you.
Dr. Ben Weston is the Chief Health Policy Officer for Milwaukee County and Associate Professor of Medicine at the Medical College of Wisconsin. Our weekly wellness check with Dr. Ben Weston. Greetings, Doctor.
Oh, how are you?
I'm doing great. So we have flipped the calendar to April here. It is National Minority Health Month. Great opportunity to highlight some of the great things happening in Milwaukee County to help advance health equity. Where's a good spot to begin?
on National Minority Health Month, and it also, we are coming up on 5 years since Milwaukee County was the first in the nation to declare racism a public health crisis back in May of 2019. So lots going on at the county, lots that's gone on in the last 5 years, really all around looking at everything, every service we provide through a health equity lens. And that comes through in a lot of different ways. We have the EVE model that we developed that helps us target resources around the pandemic, around substance use disorder, around cardiac arrest and more to the most medically, socially vulnerable and affected communities. We also saw the shifting of the mental health emergency services from TOSA to 53205, our no wrong door philosophy at DHHS, harm reduction vending machines, the list goes on, but looking at health through an equity lens.
This year's theme is be the source for better health. What does that mean to you?
I think be the source to better health really comes down to our no wrong door philosophy at DHHS. When you call the crisis line, whether it's a housing crisis, whether it's veteran services, whether it's mental health, need for disabilities, you call that line and we'll help connect you up with services, whether it's county services, municipal services. We have a lot going on in Milwaukee County to support the health of the community.
Dr. Ben Weston joining us here on Wisconsin's Midday News. Dr. Weston, you've been on the forefront of putting into place a wide range of harm reduction tools available throughout Milwaukee County, including the harm reduction vending machines, which are gaining popularity. Last week, Governor Evers signed some legislation here that decriminalizes the use of xylazine testing strips. What's the significance of this move?
So xylazine use has really increased dramatically in our county, as we're seeing around the country. So we went from 4 xylazine-related overdose deaths in 2020, 4 deaths, to 140 last year. That's more than 1 out of 4 overdose deaths in the county that involve xylazine. Now, as a reminder, folks who don't know, this is an animal tranquilizer. It leads to people stopping breathing. But what's so problematic is it doesn't respond to the naloxone nasal spray. And that's why xylazine test strips are so important. They can detect that xylazine for substance users. And I'm sure there's doubters out there, but the evidence shows, as it does with fentanyl test strips, that not only will folks use these test strips before using drugs, but they change their behavior. Mm-hmm. They use the drugs in a safer manner if the tests show positivity.
So how will the public access these strips?
Well, so the decriminalization just happened. We're working to get on our hands on some for Milwaukee County, whether we're getting them in our vending machines. We're handing out naloxone and harm reduction kits out of sheriff vehicles, out of ambulances, out of fire trucks, with no questions asked. There's lots of ways to access harm reduction. It's been a critical part of reducing deaths from overdose in Milwaukee County, and decriminalizing them is a really important step in that process.
We've seen some positive steps forward here statewide here, Dr. Weston, with Outagamie County following suit here with similar offerings to those who live in that area.
Right. These sort of no barrier ways to access harm reduction, whether it's vending machines, whether it's health departments, community centers, are really critical because it's attacking the problem head on by reducing deaths, giving folks the opportunity to enter into recovery.
Dr. Ben Weston joining us here on Wisconsin's Midday News. I had a press release late last week. Milwaukee County has opened a crisis stabilization house to expand mental health services. Crisis stabilization houses are now available. What will these be used for?
That's right. On April 1st, the Department of Health and Human Services actually opened 2 of these newly remodeled crisis stabilization houses. These are pretty unique. They have the goal of providing short-term crisis intervention services. We're talking to 60 to 90 days for folks experiencing a mental health crisis, whether they need stabilization, medication, clinical support. And this is an alternative to that traditional inpatient hospitalization option. So they give individual plans of treatment for folks experiencing mental health crises.
Dr. Weston, have you been paying attention to this man who had the transplant, the pig kidney? He just went home. It's a fascinating story.
Yeah, transplant medicine is really moving in exciting directions. The idea of not having to use human organs, but being able to use animal organs or other sort of things to advance the health of folks is really groundbreaking.
It was an amazing story. 62-year-old man, he's in need of a kidney, couldn't find a donor, just it wasn't available. They genetically kind of reconfigured a pig kidney for him, and he seems to be doing okay. Just an unbelievable story. Incredible advancements. Hey, we're getting into the summer season. I know folks are kind of looking for work, and you know what's at the county level and in need. So if people are looking for a job and you want to maybe help out and catch some rays, Milwaukee needs lifeguards, Dr. Weston.
That's right. You don't have to ask around very much. You'll find that our county pools are such an important part of so many communities. And we know, we'll talk a little bit about science here. We know that folks who live by and have access to pools have improved mood and improved well-being. We talk about green spaces, but this is blue spaces that pools create and enhance the health of those communities. But as you mentioned, it's critical to have lifeguards. And just like every community pretty much in the country, we're seeing a lifeguard shortage. But it's a great job. It pays $16 an hour. That's the starting rate. Hours are flexible, whether people have classes or whatever else. And you can get the training to save a life.
Are young people inquiring? Because we do know how critical it is. We've seen pools in the county in the past that haven't been able to open because we haven't had the lifeguards. So, and you're right, it's just a fantastic job to be out there in the summer.
That's exactly right. We want to be able to open every single pool that we have in Milwaukee County, but we can't do it without enough folks. And we do depend a lot on younger folks to do this. So if you're out there, you're looking for a summer job, this is a great one to jump into.
I should have done that as a kid. I worked at the Sunglass Hut instead at Brookfield Square Mall. Not a bad second option, but a lifeguard would have been better for me. I would have enjoyed that. Dr. Ben Weston joins us every week here. Absolutely. It's a great job. Our weekly wellness check with Dr. Ben Weston, yep. Chief Health Policy Officer of Milwaukee County and Associate Professor of Medicine at the Medical College of Wisconsin. A busy man. Thank you for your time, Dr. Weston.
Thank you. We'll talk to you soon.
You bet. It's 11:55 on WTMJ. The news is next.
WTMJ's John Mercier here. Join me as we count down to the RNC in Milwaukee. We'll talk to the biggest names across the political landscape.
From the Wisconsin Alliance for Civic Trust, David Haynes.
The incidence of actual voter fraud is very, very, very small. I've seen it said before that there's way more credit card fraud than there's voter fraud, and we still use credit cards.
Right, yeah.
Full podcast available on WTMJ.com or text RNC to 855-616-1620 and get a link sent directly to you. It's the countdown to the RNC podcast, only here on WTMJ.
We've told you about Moses Adara,
the diamond cutter who created the Kessler 81,
the magical diamond that vibrates with light.
Kessler's works with crazy diamond cutters,
geniuses who create wonderful, spectacular,
crazy diamond shapes.
The one thing these crazy genius diamonds all have in common
is that they explode with light.
The Kessler emerald cut diamond sends out rippling waves of light, like water lapping onto a beach.
The Kessler Square Radiant Diamond glows like the sun on the horizon.
Sometimes sunrise.
Sometimes sunset.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Ask to see the rippling waves of light, like water on the beach.
Ask to see the glow that looks like sunrise and sunset.
Ask to see the Kessler Crazy Genius Diamonds.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
To find the Kesslers nearest you, visit KesslersDiamonds.com.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Greg Mancik here to tell you about my friends over at the Hounds and Tap in Menominee Falls. It's a state-of-the-art facility and the ultimate hangout for hounds and humans. Grab a drink at the tavern, meet others while your pup enjoys the dog park. That's a mud-free dog park, by the way. Fun, happy, clean, and a great environment for everyone. The Hounds and Tap also provides doggy daycare, boarding, and professional grooming services. We take our greyhound there regularly. Learn more about their services. Check out thehoundsandtap.com. That's thehoundsandtap.com.
Visit family-owned Ken Michaels Furniture and our in-store design centers where you'll still find beautiful, luxurious, heirloom quality American-made furniture. Right now, save 30 to 35% store-wide and take advantage of our complimentary design services. Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today. Sleep better and save more with mattresses from Milwaukee Mattress and Ken Michaels Furniture. Handcrafted in our Milwaukee factory, our mattresses utilize natural materials like cotton cushioning, which dissipates body heat, Doma wool quilts for warm wintry nights and cool summer evenings, and natural latex providing superior conformability and pressure relief for aching joints. Stop in today at any Ken Michaels Furniture store and save up to 50% compared to national brands.
I'm WTMJ's Sandy Max. What makes senior living at Three Pillars so special? It's all about living life how you choose. Take it from my friend Bill at Three Pillars.
I've found all the sociability I need at Three Pillars. We have all kinds of activities. We have a supper club every month, movies, concerts, cards, and especially bridge, which I love to play. And so I am just as content as I can be. I really would recommend it to anybody.
Schedule a tour today at threepillars.org.
Since 1946, Ansay & Associates has provided insurance to help secure businesses and families throughout Wisconsin. With custom coverage and superior customer service, Ansay & Associates can provide all of your insurance needs. Visit ansay.com today and get a free consultation with one of our strategists. Or come see us in person at any of our local offices. Ansay & Associates, securing and protecting your American dream.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station. Trusted, relevant, locally owned, locally programmed. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ Milwaukee.
It's 12 o'clock. I'm Greg Matzik. This is Wisconsin's Midday News for Thursday, April 4th, your top story, early morning argument and a court appearance for Jesse Wang.
I'm Jessica Talia. Manhunt underway in Tennessee.
Kind of a crummy day today, kind of a holding pattern as well, with snow and rain in the forecast, down to 33 for your overnight low. The rain should eventually dissipate, and you'll get some peaks of the sun tomorrow with a high of 43 degrees, back into the 50s. Over the weekend, it's 35 degrees in Milwaukee at 12:01. From the WTMJ Breaking Newsroom, the boyfriend of missing Elijah Vu's mother in court today. Manitowoc County Detective Michael Herman testifying during a preliminary hearing shared more information about punishment methods administered by Vu's caretaker, Jesse Vang.
Did he indicate whether the victim would get tired or not?
He did indicate during the interview that he believed that the child would become tired from standing for long periods of time, yes.
Vu's mother, Katrina Bauer, is scheduled to appear in court on April 26th.
A longtime Wisconsin politician and former Wisconsin congressman may attempt to return to Washington.
Peter Barca is the current Wisconsin Secretary of Revenue. He was a U.S. congressman from 1993 to 1995 and tells me he could run for the seat again.
Well, I've not made a decision on that. It's something I've looked at, and I've had quite a bit of encouragement. So, you know, our pattern has been to work across the aisle and try and get things done. And so that's why I'm at least looking at it.
Brian Stile currently holds the seat and is running for re-election. Peter Barca has already announced he's leaving his revenue position. John Merkier, WTMJ News.
Decision Wisconsin, Green Bay OBGYN Kristen Lyerly announced her campaign for outgoing U.S. Congressman Mike Gallagher's seat this morning at an event at Hinterland Brewing. Gallagher will step down from his position later this month. Two Republicans, former State Senator Roger Roth and State Senator Andre Jacques, have already announced their candidacies. Lyerly will join WTMJ's Spanning the State today at 1:15.
Ford is making some adjustments to its electric vehicle plans.
An electric pickup truck and SUV from Ford were expected to hit the road next year. Now the company's delaying both trucks amid slowing growth in the EV sector. Interbrand's Greg Silverman says the audience for EVs is changing.
There's an old term and a concept about crossing the chasm when you move from early adopters to the broader general market.
It's also prompted automakers to give hybrids a second look. Ford says it expects to offer hybrid versions of all its vehicles by 2030. Mike Dubosky, ABC News.
General Motors also recently delayed some planned EVs and announced it's reinvesting in hybrid technology.
Well, relatives of the late Dr. Martin Luther King held ceremonies in multiple cities today to mark the 26th anniversary of the civil rights leader's assassination. Bernice King, the daughter of Martin Luther and Coretta Scott King, said the family is committed to carrying the message of nonviolence.
We know the legacy of Martin Luther King Jr. and Mrs. Coretta Scott King are so critical to the times that we're living in. Very turbulent, troubling, difficult, challenging times.
Dr. King was shot and killed on April 4th, 1968. A ceremony was held today in Memphis, another one held in Atlanta. Time for news about your money in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Pretty good day for the indices, with the Dow Jones currently up 171 points at 39,298. The NASDAQ up 174 points at 16,452. And the S&P 500 up today about 39 points at 5250 and change. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Check out annexwealth.com. Click on the Get Started button today.
Sports, traffic, and weather next. Sunny Unlimited, WTMJ News Time is 12:04.
This report sponsored by the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network.
Heart disease won't stop us. Diabetes won't slow us down. Allergies, high blood pressure, shoulder pain, cancer. Nothing will keep us from pushing Wisconsin ahead. Because with the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, forward progress is what we stand for. That means always pushing and always innovating. With new technologies and breakthrough treatments that make life better, whether we're sick or well. It means providing more convenience and more ways to receive medical excellence for all your health needs, for big and small. It means being there for you. Our family, caring for yours. So let's keep raising the bar. Let's keep testing the limits of what medicine can do. Let's push ahead and make life here as great as it can be. Visit Fradert.com to find out how.
No one wanted to hire me. They just saw my disability, but not me. I worked hard to get the education and the skills needed to thrive. I was ready to work. Then someone believed in me and said yes.
And once you say yes, ThinkAbility Wisconsin will be there, providing transition and workforce support for people with disabilities and their employers to help shape a better future for all. It all starts when you say yes. Join the movement at thinkabilitywi.org.
Sharks. Most people see them as a threat, but we see a potential cure. At UW Health Carbone Cancer Center, we're the only team in the world researching whether antibodies from sharks can be used to fight cancer. A discovery that would revolutionize the future of cancer care, turning possibilities into remarkable realities. So one day, instead of what if, we can ask, what's next? UW Health Carbone Cancer Center. Remarkable.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All sports desk. A day off for the 4-1 Brewers, who welcome in the Mariners for a three-game weekend series beginning Friday night. The Oakland A's are planning to move to Sacramento for the 25 through 27 seasons, with an option to play there as well in 2028. The A's continue to explore Las Vegas as a future permanent home. And with six games left on the regular season schedule, the Bucks own a game and a half lead over the Cavaliers for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race.
Let's check out the roads with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver traffic. It is a wet commute for this Thursday afternoon. 894 northbound, the Hale Interchange to the Zoo Interchange. That's a one-minute delay. Also, the construction spot, I-43 southbound, Brown Deer Road to downtown. That's a three-minute delay this afternoon.
Snowy, rainy mix today. Cloudy and breezy with a high of 41 degrees. A chance of a rain-snow mix tonight with a low of 33. We'll see a peak of the sun on Friday with decreasing clouds and a high of 43. Saturday, sunny and 50. Sunday, a chance of showers with a high of 46. It's 37 degrees in Milwaukee at 12:07.
Live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios in downtown Milwaukee, it's Wisconsin's Midday News, making stories come to life. Now, here are your hosts, Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai.
Back again for a full edition of Wisconsin's Midday News after our shortened show yesterday. Sorry we couldn't bring you a Brewers win. We tried.
I know. But you know what? We weren't going to win them all. We knew that, right?
Well, as soon as we brought up free burgers from George Webb's, and we were way too early to do that, but as soon as we brought it up, that's when things went downhill.
We should have knocked on wood.
The pressure of the free burgers. So no Brewers game today. They're back at it tomorrow for a weekend series against the Mariners. Some big stories we are covering as we flip the clock to noon.
It's now at noon on Wisconsin's Midday News.
Rescue operations are in full force in Taiwan today for hundreds of people still trapped after the strongest earthquake the island has seen in a quarter century. Listen to these numbers. At least 10 people were killed, and that's at least. That's an important part of that. More than 1,000 injured, and it's estimated about 700 people remain unaccounted for right now. ABC's Joyce Wong is in Taipei covering another angle of the story.
Yesterday's earthquake also caused several of Taiwan's chip makers, including TSMC, the world's largest, to suspend their operation. TSMC said that after the quake hit early Wednesday morning, it rushed to evacuate employees in some of its facilities at the Science Park in Hsinchu of northern Taiwan to ensure their safety. Joyce Wong, ABC News, Taipei, Taiwan.
That was a 7.4 magnitude earthquake. And when I was saying the number or the words at least are important because at least 10 people were killed, but we have 700 people who they have not been able to find yet. So you know that number is going to go up and probably up drastically.
Yeah, the video is absolutely frightening and horrifying if you've seen it on social media. Well, it's the ultimate in clickbait, and I'm guilty. We're in April.
I did it too.
Well, USA Today has come out with its first power rankings of the season for the NFL. All right, you got me, USA Today. You got Jessica, too. The draft isn't even here yet. It's 3 weeks away. The schedule hasn't been released, but the Packers check it at number 5 on USA Today's list.
I wanted to know, of course. I mean, I clicked it on it immediately. I'm like, where are we? Where? If you're a fan, you want to know.
I get sucked into this stuff way too often, I admit. So the Chiefs are number 1 on the list for those keeping score at home. The big story out of Kansas City, though, if you've followed this, they had a failed tax hike to fund renovations at Arrowhead Stadium. So I know things have stalled in Green Bay with the lease and it being a community-owned team and whatnot. The rules are a little different up there. Stalled conversations in Green Bay. You get a no vote in Kansas City for Arrowhead, one of the iconic stadiums in all of the NFL.
Well, and you think about it, I mean, the Brewers are getting the money, but not everybody's happy about it. At some point, people say, hey, you know, do we need to keep footing the bill?
Very good point. So we'll see what is to become of that. I feel pretty good about the long-term history of Lambeau Field. I don't think it's going away anytime soon.
Oh, no. I would agree with you there. Happening now at Healthcare Field in the shadows of American Family Field, it is the Brewers' first Drive for Charity event of the season. This one focuses on our fur friends, collecting pet supplies for the Wisconsin Humane Society. WTMJ's Debbie Lozaga joins us live to explain how you can help, too. Debbie, what do they need?
Oh, they need all sorts of stuff. Think about what you would need as if you just got a new puppy. You need the potty pads, you need the blankets, you need the toys, definitely. Treats, they need cat litter for the kitties. They're collecting peanut butter that's great for treats and for fun for the puppies. And we're also needing some money as well. So if you do donate, we're collecting all the way until 3 o'clock today, but they're also collecting at the homestand this weekend, throughout the weekend. Homestand. So you do get stuff too. You get Pat Murphy Ricky Week collectible pins as well as a Brewers hat. So it's a lot of fun out there and it's going to be helping them out a lot. It's for the Brewers Community Foundation teaming up with 620 WTMJ benefiting the Wisconsin Humane Society.
Hey, Deb, have they said what not to bring? Sometimes, you know, you think you have something that's going to be perfect and maybe it's not so much.
Yeah, they can't take anything like already opened food or anything like that. They want to be careful with the peanut butter that you want to make sure it doesn't have any xylitol in it. That is a sweetener that can actually be toxic for a lot of animals. So stuff like that. They want to make sure that it's relatively new stuff, not too chewed up or anything like that as far as the toys are concerned.
Nothing expired either because we had a listener who had such good intent and brought a bunch of treats and wrote in and said, oh, they were slightly expired and couldn't take them. So
just a good
reminder. And, man, we appreciate the effort, though.
Exactly. And don't forget, you can also text into the Talk and Text line, PETS, to get the online donation information. You can donate money directly online. And, by the way, every penny that we're collecting is going straight to the Wisconsin Humane Society.
Love that, Deb. Good stuff. Bring her a hot chocolate, Deb. Great work. Thank you. We'll talk again soon.
You got it. Thanks, guys.
You got it. It's 12:12 on WTMJ. Call it 12:13. Coming up next, Joel Brennan, Greater Milwaukee Committee President, will join us. His response to the Milwaukee Public Schools referendum. The Greater Milwaukee Committee was in favor of voting no on that referendum. Well, now it's here. and it's going to happen. What is the stance of the Greater Milwaukee Committee and business leaders in the community? We'll check in with Joel coming up after this.
The Political Power Hour with Steve Scafidi.
Is politics is going to be stupid this year?
Hearing from political experts from across Wisconsin and beyond.
You know, you say that, and I think it's actually going to be deadly serious. There could be stupid things involved in it.
People could argue that what we're seeing now is stupid, but they are really trying to reach a different demographic of voters who may have never gone to the polls before, and what is stupid to some may actually work for others.
Weekdays from 9 to 10 on WTMJ.
Hey, does your home need a new defensive coach? Have wind, cold, or water breached? Well, I recommend Siding Unlimited. How's it holding up in the weather of this week? Wind and cold getting through your windows? No good. Siding Unlimited can fix that. Is water challenging your roof? Well, Siding Unlimited fixes that too. What about the siding? Is it looking offensive? Letting the elements through, perhaps? Well, fixing that is Siding Unlimited's first and continuing specialty. When weather's offense beats your home's defense, you contact Siding Unlimited. The name says it all. They are siding, but a whole lot more. Whatever the breach, put Siding Unlimited in the game for you. And check out their work on display at their showroom in Brookfield. They're waiting for you at Siding Unlimited. Find them online at SidingUnlimited.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercier here. When it comes to painting, don't do it yourself. Call the pros at your local neighborhood CertaPro Painters. That's what we did. CertaPro came out, gave us choices, walked us through the process, and then when they were there, it was quick, it was easy. Our home is beautiful. Excellent workmanship all the way around. It's CertaPro Painters. Each CertaPro Painters business is independently owned and operated right here in Wisconsin. Schedule your free estimate online at CertaPro.com. That's Certa with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
Kind of a rainy, snowy day in southeastern Wisconsin. Not a great one. Sort of a system hovering over the greater portion of our listening area. Down to 33 overnight. Should see some decrease in clouds and a peak of the sun tomorrow with a high of 43. It's 36 degrees in Milwaukee at 12:15. Joel Brennan is the president of the Greater Milwaukee Committee. He joins us every Thursday at about 12:16. Hello, Joel. Whenever I see your smiling face, I have to smile myself. Working on our connection with Joel. Maybe he's just getting into the beautiful dulcet tones of James Taylor.
I was just going to say, that's one we haven't played in a while. Have you ever seen James Taylor play in concert?
He was at Summerfest, or has been to Summerfest a couple of times. I must admit, I didn't stay for the entire thing, but it was back in the hand stamp days. You could kind of walk in and check out a little bit and walk out at your leisure.
I went not that long ago, well after the hand stamp days, and maybe 3 or 4 years ago or so, but it was a really great concert. A lot of people were surprised. They're like, you're going to see James Taylor? I'm like, he's a classic. But I mean, I love all kinds of music, so he was really good. He had a ton of pictures behind him. You could kind of just see his life go by as well.
A living room sort of atmosphere.
It was kind of like that.
Well, speaking of a guy who can bring the house down, it's Joel Brennan of the Greater Milwaukee Committee. Hello, Joel.
Hello, Greg. How are you doing?
Doing well. So last we spoke, we weren't sure what the results of the MPS referendum were going to be. A very close, very narrow vote in favor of the referendum. I know the Greater Milwaukee Committee was not for the referendum, feeling that it was all just sort of rushed. What is the position of the Greater Milwaukee Committee now that it's a yes?
Well, you know, certainly what was proven on Tuesday night is that people in the and the kids in public schools, and that's a good thing. I think all of us are supportive of the kids who are in those schools and supportive of better outcomes. And so the community has made the decision to invest more local resources into the public schools. And we're going to be right alongside them. I'm going to hope that the business and civic community is going to be alongside MPS in trying to make sure that we have better outcomes. The thing that's a little disappointing in all this is there's been a lot of anger, and it's anger directed at each other and at, you know, certain interests of this. I think there should be anger about what the outcomes are. And I hope that what we're going to do, and this is what we talked about even in the last few weeks, is bring people together now and see what are we going to do that is going to bring more creative, innovative solutions to the challenges that we have in public education in the K-12 schools in Milwaukee. So, you know, I think these are elections are time when people kind of their passions are inflamed and everybody's
– I think we lost our connection with Joel there, who is on a remote location right now out of state. But, you know, commenting, one of the business groups commenting on the referendum was the MMAC with a similar position to Joel. I think we do have him back here right now as the Greater Milwaukee Committee president joins us on the line from St. Louis. I don't know if they've had similar referendums in St. Louis, but nonetheless, $252 million approved, a yes vote, 51-49, a very narrow vote passing yes. But now what do you do with it, right? And as Joel mentions, it's a time to get together and figure out a plan moving forward, highlighting the outcomes. Student outcomes is one of the headliners here to try and get corrected. Correct, Joel?
It sounds like we don't have Joel back yet, but I'll tell you what, it's one of those things, now that we know this is a yes and MPS is going to get the money, you wonder how quickly do we see those better outcomes? I mean, it doesn't happen overnight. You'd like it to, especially when we're talking about this much money, right? But we've got to get the plan in place, figure it out exactly, and then we have to put it into place, right? And then wait for, hopefully, better results, better outcomes. But that's going to be a while.
I also think an interesting part of the discussion is what to do with the existing infrastructure, because these buildings just aren't full, and that's another part of the puzzle, and I think why so many on the opposite end were saying, wait a minute, hold off on the referendum, let's close the buildings down that should be closed down, maybe put them up for sale, and then see what you need, as we welcome Joel back in. Joel, you're continuing your conversation on how to move forward together to try and improve outcomes.
Right, and what you're just saying now, Greg, about the infrastructure and the fact that MPS has far more buildings than they have students to fill them now. And I think there's things that we can do innovatively and creatively on that. Even just before the election, Keith Posley and I, the superintendent, had a discussion. He was talking about those buildings and the fact that they have had buildings that have been closed for several years that they have not yet been able to dispose of. Well, you know, can we get federal or state resources to be able to help the system mitigate that or to put those back into productive use? I think those are the kind of conversations, the productive conversations that we have to have now. And I'm looking forward to those because, again, I hope I didn't cut out too early in my prior comments, but, you know, some of this is people being angry at each other. I think what we should be doing is being angry at the outcomes and figuring out what we can do to make things better for our kids. That's what they deserve. That's what we need to do.
And I think they did come out yesterday during the press conference and say, we will be looking at some of those empty buildings and what we need to do with them. So at least that conversation is now happening. Joel, is there something else that you think this has to be part of the solution that you'd personally like to see?
Well, what I'd like to see is that we have more conversations about how do we make productive use of the resources that are in the community. And just in the last 3 or 4 weeks doing some research, I've heard of other communities, the Charlotte-Mecklenburg School District, where the business and civic community has done things like loan executives to the school district and figure out how there are some challenges that they have inside the school district that people who are in the business community may have an answer for or may be able to lend a hand toward. But, you know, I just think that there are better ways that we can convene and put people together to find solutions. And it's solutions for all the kids who are going to school in Milwaukee, not just in the K-12 system in the MPS, but also in the choice and the charter schools. Because, you know, while we have some standouts amongst all of those, we also have some really challenging situations and challenging outcomes, and we need to do better for all of them.
Greater Milwaukee Committee President Joel Brennan joining us here on Wisconsin's Midday News. I saw this yesterday, Joel. The city of Milwaukee is redesigning West Michigan Street from North Water to North 8th to try and improve safety, comfort, accessibility, make it a little more bike and pedestrian friendly. I feel like Michigan Street is one of those, as it is, you know, kind of on the flank of where our studios are located, that could use a bit of a facelift, but this seems to be a growing trend here in Milwaukee to try and improve safety, walkability, comfort, and accessibility for everybody.
Right, I think that's part of a hallmark of Mayor Johnson and what he's been trying to do. And I think this is something you've started to see this in and around the downtown. You know, Michigan Street can kind of be the place that time forgot. There are, you know, some, as you head further west there are abandoned buildings, and there are some areas that appear a little desolate, but that's also where the new soccer stadium is planned for and could breathe new life into that west side of downtown. And so all this, I think, is a part of how do you attract people, how do you move people in and around the downtown in new and exciting ways, and do it not just for people who are in cars, but also pedestrians, people on bicycles, you know, make sure that we have multimodal opportunities for people to get in and around the downtown. So I'm excited about that. I'm excited about what's going on Van Buren Street. People coming in and around the downtown, I think, are going to see some new and exciting ways to get in and through it.
Do you think more people are biking in Milwaukee? Because just on social media, I feel like there's a louder conversation these days of wanting more bike lanes and just hearing from the bikers. Do you think that we do have more people biking in the city, or just that we were kind of maybe behind the times compared to some other cities in bikeability?
I think we're catching up in some ways, but there's been a passionate group of people who have been on bikes and who bicycle in Wisconsin, if you can believe it, 12 months out of the year. And I think they are getting better organized. We've done some really good things around the sharing programs in Milwaukee. And I just think that this is part of a culture. And as we draw younger people into the community, they don't all want to own a car. They ride buses, they ride bikes, you know, so they do things that force our hand, if we want to be the type of community that attracts those people, to make sure that they have ways of getting around.
It's so true that you say that, because I was just talking with one of our reporters here at 620 WTMJ this morning, Adam Roberts. He rides his bike from time to time, more often than not, but I was surprised to put my coat away in the coat closet and see his bike today, because it's not real nice. Joel, I know you're out of town, but it's kind of one of those, you know, wet and crummy days again. But he's like, yep, if I can bike, I want to do it, and today was an okay day to do so.
And that's what we're starting. That's who you want to attract. You want to attract people who are going to do everything, who want to get around your community in every way, and we've got to give them opportunities to do that, because that's what's proven is when you put these things out there, people will use them, and you'll become a much more bike-friendly place and draw that type of people. And I think that's what we want to be as a community.
Greater Milwaukee Committee President Joel Brennan joining us every Thursday here on Wisconsin's Midday News. We appreciate it, Joel. We'll talk again next week.
All right. Sorry for the technical difficulties. Thank you.
Hey, no problem. Thanks, at all. It's 12:25 on WTMJ. News coming up in just a minute.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Helping people and families seriously injured in accidents and standing up for victims to take the burden off their shoulders. Talking about Gruber Law Offices, family-run business, been doing it in Wisconsin for over 35 years and getting results that speak for themselves. Gruber, one of the largest personal injury firms in the Midwest. They're locally known but nationally recognized as one of the best. David and his team, they do it the right way. Give them a call, one call, and that's all. You've heard the tagline before, right? Well, it is much more than just a tagline or something that sounds good in an advertisement. It's the truth. Gruber-Law.com. Find out more about their firm. Find out how they give back to the community. That really is a staple of Gruber Law Offices. Involved in the community. It's a big deal for them. 414-276-6666, should you need to reach them. It's Gruber Law Offices, 414-276-6666.
Hey, this is Steve Scafidi for Advent. I had some snoring issues that kept my wife up at night. That led to poor sleep and a lot of tired mornings on the radio, and nobody wants that, trust me. But it's simply, my nose wasn't working the way it should. I decided to go to Advent for a quick 30-minute visit, one of their great facilities, talk to a bunch of their doctors. They really put me at ease. After a really simple sleep study at home, in my own bed, they determined the root cause of my problem had to do with my sinuses and nasal passages in my breathing triangle. I didn't even know I had a breathing triangle until I went to see Advent. After a short procedure done in office, I'm back to breathing well, and my wife and I are both back to sleeping through the whole night. The best sleep we've ever had, that could be you. If you struggle with restless nights like I did, take the time to see how Advent can help. To find out how breathing well and sleeping well can make your life and your nights a whole lot better, go to AdventKnows.com, schedule an appointment today. Because Advent knows, when you breathe well, you live better.
Haul away big deals this Thursday through Sunday at Fleet Farm's Truckload Savings Event. like 40-pound bags of black oil sunflower seed, on sale for $14.99. Save on a Blackstone 28-inch griddle with cover and accessories, just $249.99. Pick up 4 bags of garden soil, on sale for $10. And save on 40 pounds of Morton water softening pellets for only $5.79. Stock up on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Nagging pain lasting for months, difficulty performing everyday tasks, not moving like you'd like, it's time to see the doctor. And I recommend Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Anytime I've needed care, the appointments are timely, no waiting weeks to be seen, and no pressure to have surgery. It's about getting the right diagnosis and choosing a treatment plan that fits your life. No question where I turn if I'm injured again. The experts in care at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. It's orthowisconsin.com.
Outdoor living is great, but it's best when it's at your own home. Well, there's a company called Outdoor Living Unlimited that will build you a deck, a patio, pergola, fire pit, all manner of things to enhance outdoor living at your place, even an outdoor kitchen. Get started right away. Contact Outdoor Living Unlimited now. Get your yard project onto Outdoor Living Unlimited's calendar while there's still openings. OutdoorLivingUnlimited.com.
St. Vincent de Paul Milwaukee has expanded into our new 76th and Bradley Road location, where thrifters will find hundreds of bargains on everything, from clothing to furniture, electronics, home goods, and more. Our inventory is always changing, and new deals pop up every day. We're accepting donations, too, at our convenient drive-through donation area. Help us help others. St. Vincent de Paul at 76th and Bradley Road in Milwaukee is now open.
Ooh, you're gonna love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
It's 12:30. I'm Greg Matzik. This is Wisconsin's Midday News. Your top story, new details on the missing Two River Boys' home life.
And I'm Jessica Tye. New reaction to the Milwaukee Public Schools referendum passing.
Showers and snow today. Cloudy and breezy with a high of 41. A slight chance of a rain-snow mix tonight with a low of 33. Clouds on the decrease tomorrow. We should see a peak of the sun and a high of 43 degrees. It's 35 in Milwaukee at 12:30.
ABC News, I'm Michelle Franzen. For the first time since Israeli airstrikes killed 7 humanitarian aid workers distributing food in Gaza, President Biden spoke to Israel's prime minister. That call just wrapping up. The president publicly expressed outrage over the deaths this week. ABC's Karen Travers says the White House has not provided a readout yet of that call.
The president's under increasing pressure to have something change with what Israel is doing in Gaza. And this phone call today gives the president that opportunity to present that message to Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu.
In Ukraine, President Zelensky says Russia carried out fresh attacks today in Kharkiv, killing 4 people and injuring a dozen others. Days after the major earthquake in Taiwan, the search continues for people trapped in partially collapsed buildings. At least 10 people died in the worst earthquake to hit Taiwan in 25 years. And major rain and heavy snow hitting the northeast after a classic nor'easter. Power also being restored to thousands. This is ABC News.
Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time is 12:31. The boyfriend of missing Elijah Vu's mother in court today. Manitowoc County Detective Michael Herman testifying during a preliminary hearing that Jesse Vang shared with him the daily protocol for while Vu was under Vang's supervision, including how often the child's diapers were changed.
Mr. Vang advised that he changed the child's diaper at least one time per day.
And through your course of employment and law enforcement over 30 years, based upon your experience, typically do children need to be changed as far as diapers more than once a day?
Yes.
Vang, along with Vu's mother, Katrina Bauer, have both been charged with child neglect but are still not charged in Vu's disappearance. Bauer will be back in court April 26th. Vu has been missing since February 20th.
New reaction now to the narrow victory for a $252 million Milwaukee Public Schools referendum. Greater Milwaukee Committee President Joel Brendan joined us on Wisconsin's Midday News during our last half hour. While the organization campaigned against the referendum, they'll support the will of the people.
The community has made the decision to invest more local resources into the public schools, and we're going to be right alongside them. I'm going to hope that the business and civic community is going to be alongside MPS in trying to make sure that we have better outcomes.
MPS tells WTMJ community engagement sessions detailing plans for the money will happen later this year.
Decision, Wisconsin. Green Bay OBGYN Kristen Lierley will run this fall to replace outgoing U.S. Congressman Mike Gallagher. Gallagher will step down from his 8th congressional district seat later this month. Two Republicans, former State Senator Roger Roth and State Senator Andre Jacques, have already announced their candidacies. Lierley will join WTMJ Spanning the State today at 1:15.
Rollout of the new fare collection system for the Milwaukee County Transit System's Connect One Bus Rapid Transit has been delayed another week. MCTS tells WTMJ weather conditions have prevented the installation of fare validators at BRT stations. The fare rollout is now scheduled for April 15th.
Sports, traffic, and weather are next. Siding and Limited, WTMJ News Time is 12:33.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this. Who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated? Might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
With rampant inflation affecting so many families and businesses, this will save you money. WTMJ's John Mercier here every Thursday at the Mine Shaft Restaurant in Hartford. When you buy one pizza, you get one free. Buy two pizzas, get two free. Buy 10 pizzas, get 10 free pizzas. There's no limit. Coaches, bring in your soccer, baseball, softball, tennis, track team for free pizza. Your players will also love that world-class game room. It's super affordable. Team bonding. Bring in pizza today for your dedicated employees and clients. They'll really appreciate you, and your second pizza is free. Order now, pick up your pizza shortly, or dine in. No cooking, no cleaning. Take a couple home for your family. Wherever you live, it's worth the drive for your free pizza today at the Mine Shaft in beautiful downtown Hartford and in Oshkosh. A reminder, the Mine Shaft just lowered their Friday fish fry to $4.99. That's crazy. $4.99. It's big food. It's big fun. It's the Mine Shaft. Visit mineshaftrestaurant.com.
As it looks for a long-term and permanent home, still have Las Vegas in the mix. And the Bucks own a 1.5-game lead over the Cavaliers for the second position in the Eastern Conference playoff race with 6 games to play.
Taking a look at the roads with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic. We do have a couple disabled vehicles out of the system, but that's not causing any major delays. Our problem spots right now are the construction areas. I-43 southbound, Brown Deer Road to downtown. That's a 3-minute delay right now. 894 northbound, Hale Interchange to the Zoo Interchange. Just a 1-minute delay.
Traffic is sponsored by Hall Mazda Milwaukee. Visit hallmazdamilwaukee.com.
While you're navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you see something we should know about, call the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line.
414-238-9329.
Well, the consistency of the snow and rain should taper off here before too long. Slight chance of rain-snow mix tonight with a low of 33. Clouds on the decrease tomorrow, a chance of seeing some sun with a high of 43. Sunny on Saturday with a high of 50. It's 36 degrees in Milwaukee at 12:37.
L-Line fully opens 1 week from today. It's the Milwaukee Streetcar's first new route extension. Joining us live in the studio to talk about the milestone is the Milwaukee Commissioner of Public Works, Gerald Krushke. Thanks for joining us, Gerald.
Absolutely. Good to be
here. This new route has been a long time coming. I traveled to the factory in Pennsylvania to get the first look at our streetcars being built. That was back in 2018. And I remember reporting on construction that would start for the next route that spring. That was 6 years ago.
Yes, it was 6 years ago. So the tracks have been in place since 2018, and we're waiting for the Couture development that is on the lakefront there to complete before we could actually get this extension, which is 3/4 mile, which really touches the lakefront and gives that access to the downtowners.
And at the end of the day, remind people why it did take so long. I mean, it really was, it hinged a lot on the Couture.
Yeah, so it was it's a really good partnership because it's a hub that ties into a residential unit. So we're going to be into a concourse when that opens up at the end of Michigan Avenue. So it's something that we haven't seen in Milwaukee. So you're going to have a BRT that's going to be in there. You're going to have a hop station to get that access. So it's a little different than just a regular stop that you would see normally.
So you'd be able to walk out your front door, really the front door of the Couture building, and walk right onto the hop, essentially, at a stop?
Absolutely.
The L line, named after the lakefront. So where exactly does it go for people who aren't exactly familiar?
Yeah, so right now what it's going to do, everyone goes on the M line, so it'll go up and down Wisconsin Avenue. Then you'll be able to go down Michigan all the way to the lakefront. It'll make a kind of like a horseshoe into the Couture building. There'll be there's an intermediate stop, then there's a stop at the Couture, and then it'll come down Clybourne and connect with the M line again.
So just to be sure, though, if you are jumping on, say, the last stop on that end at Burns Commons, you can't take it all the way down to the Couture. You will have to jump off and then jump on a new streetcar.
That is correct. So there is a transfer. So that's why there's two lines. There's the M and the L. So you're going to have to transfer over. In the future, we're going to look at what ridership looks like, and that configuration could change because we're going to try to cater to where the most people are getting on and off.
What do you envision for this line as it goes through the bottom of the Couture? There's the new transportation hub there. This is a big deal.
It's a huge deal. I mean, you look at all the activity that goes on at the lakefront, from the festival grounds that are there, the art museum. You have Discovery World and the residential sitting there. So, you know, if you're sitting anywhere in downtown, let's say you want to go to Summerfest later on in the year, You can park anywhere around downtown and access that without going in the congestion that's there. So for us, it's like providing that access. Even if you want to go at lunch to see the lake, you know, which would take, you know, normally a 20, 25-minute walk, you can do that now pretty quickly.
You know, if a lot of people bring up, when they talk about the hop, they say, is there ever an opportunity to get down into the Deer District? Is that part of the long-term plans at some point, or is it not feasible for whatever reason?
Oh, no, those are still in the plans. So on the backside, there's a lot of strings attached, and so we're looking at federal grants to extend all the way through. I mean, the goal of the hop is to hit the neighborhoods. I mean, go all the way to the north into Bronzeville, go all the way south into Walker's Point. It just challenges with financing, so we're continuing to look at ways we can extend it to those points.
And most of the funding for this, correct me if I'm wrong, but most of the funding for this extension was from a federal grant.
That is correct. That was a Tiger grant back in 2018.
So where are you guys as far as, I know you said it's in the works, and so many people will tell you, the hop has been so controversial from the get-go. I mean, it's, you know, you had people who could not wait for it to be here, and then you had other people who never wanted the tracks even put into the place. It's here now. It's been here for years. It's still controversial, which is wild to me. But sometimes you have people who hate the hop, who have never even got on the streetcar once. And sometimes the stuff they put out there, I'm like, that's not even true, because I have taken the hop. I take it quite a bit. So I challenge those people to actually go down and actually check out the hop and to see it. But everybody knows that we need more extensions to truly make this a big success. There's no secret about that. So what is the most likely next thing to happen?
Our next likely extension is going to go through towards Bronzeville. I mean, that's the one we have. We have basically 60% plans complete at this point. So we have tangible plans to actually move forward. Now it's just trying to get that financial piece. And we've had some challenges over the past couple of years with the change of Act 12 and what sort of funding options we can use. We had to kind of reconfigure where we're going to go. But you're right. I mean, the goal is to get to the neighborhoods and provide access to downtown. Although I will say, you know, currently we've had over 2 million riders since it's opened up, and that's 2 million less cars, you know, cluttering up the streets of Milwaukee and given access. So it's used every day by commuters, you know, to access the Amtrak station down and other options. So really for us, it's provide a transit option, get more cars off the roadway, get less clutter on them.
Jarrell Kruschke joining us in studio here on Wisconsin's Midday News, Commissioner of Public Works in the city of Milwaukee. So for a while, and I don't recall how many years it was, but there was no charge to ride the hop. That has since changed, correct? Or is it still a free service?
Still free.
So therein lies the federal grants that are required to extend its services. Is there ever any appetite for a pay-to-ride sort of model, or is the goal to try and keep it where you don't have to pay to ride, but understanding that down the road there will be maintenance and there will be things that you have to do to maintain the viability of the service?
Yeah, so we've kind of done some investigations on this, and the goal is to keep it free right now. So we do sponsorships, like if you see Potawatomi Bingo Casino is on there, and other wraps you'll see in streetcars during the year. So that's how we kind of bring in other revenue. We're trying to expand that further. We've looked at revenue options, and right now it's not feasible. We've got sister cities all across the country that if you decide to charge a fare, There's the administration cost, the collective fare. So you're not gaining as much as you actually think. Mm-hmm. And we'd rather have people utilize it and get sponsorship than actually charge someone at this point.
You just wrapped at least one of the new streetcars. I haven't seen it in person yet, but I saw it in social media. I actually reached out to get them on as well here in the next couple of days. But some really interesting artwork is on one of the streetcars now.
Yeah, it's the 414 company that's out there. So they do a lot of apparel in the Third Ward. So we started to modify to give smaller businesses an opportunity. So you used to see full streetcar wraps from head to toe. Now we're just doing center ones to give more of an economical option, but to get more local businesses on some of these streetcars.
Any chance with the Bucks? I know we kind of hit a bad spot here with losing some games, but as we go into the playoffs, that we might see a Bucks streetcar?
Not sure yet. I'm not going to unload any particular things that are in the works, but it's always a potential. I think we've had the Bucks on, I think it was last year, the year before, when they were going to championship run. We have all kinds of things that come up, so hopefully we'll see that.
Yeah. Keeping your vendor on your toes, I'm sure, aren't you? Right? Because yeah, I'm sure when it happens, you need a quick turnaround to wrap a streetcar, and that's no easy task.
No, it usually takes about 8 hours to wrap a full streetcar from head to toe. So.
Yeah.
Well, and you guys have gotten really creative, too. I mean, one of the years, I know it wasn't just the wrap, but you would walk inside, and it was like the basketball court. I mean, that was really interesting. And you've done some events on the hop as well, the city has.
Yeah, we have many events on the night. So we got, you know, hot nights. We got other things. We have music on there during Christmas time, during jazz, like during the summer times, because we're just trying to make it more of an experience than just a transportation option.
As long as we have you on, would you like to put anything out there as far as people who are driving, things that they should just remember about, you know, being good neighbors with the hop?
Yeah, that's a great segue there. I would say just, you know, there's lines painted all over the place. So when you decide to park, you know, adjacent to the hop, just stay on the other side of that line because you'll hear it honk. Just let it travel down the roadway. Cars can go right behind the hop or in front of it. It's like a vehicle going there, except it's on a fixed rail. But it's been around the city for a number of years now, so it's nothing new. It's going to be new for the businesses along Michigan and Clybourne, but, you know, this is nothing new for everyone that's there. Just be mindful of where you're parking. I think that's the biggest, you know, PSA, I would have to say.
Well, congrats on the expansion here. This is exciting stuff.
It definitely is. Yeah, the Hop's new L line fully opens 1 week from today, and you can start riding it. Thank you so much. We appreciate you joining us. That's Gerald Krushke, Milwaukee Commissioner of Public Works.
Thanks.
12:45 on WTMJ.
Hi, folks. This is Hank Albert, owner of BBC Lighting. With spring in the air, a young man's fancy turns to ceiling fans. And at BBC, he'll see all the best quality fans and their newest styles. The new fan electronics provide a great method of moving air, and with LED lights, they use less electricity than ever. We have fans in all sizes, from 24 to 96 inches wide, and their motors are warranted for life. At BBC, we advise you on the right fan for your needs, and our prices are the lowest. I guarantee it. We're open Monday through Friday from 9 to 5 and on Saturday 10 to 4 and located at 20th and St. Paul Avenue across from Sobelman's and Bachman Furniture, all near the Pottawatomie Casino. Stay safe and healthy, my friends.
Welcome back to Ask Hassilis.
If you could spend 1 month anywhere, where would you go?
Easy. I'd go to bed.
I mean anywhere in the world.
Precisely.
You'd spend the entire month in bed?
Specifically, a new Tempur-Pedic from Hassilis mattress.
Why?
Because I can take 60 months to pay for it. Through Monday, get 60 months interest-free financing on select Tempur-Pedic mattresses, plus a $300 MasterCard gift card.
60 months, that means...
You can buy a Queen Tempur-Pedic ProAdapt Hybrid with Ease Adjustable Base for just $74 a month.
And I get a $300 MasterCard gift card.
Free next-day delivery and employee-free showrooms, too.
So I can try and buy...
With no pushy sales guy.
Hang on.
What are you doing?
Searching for a travel agent to book a month-long vacation at Hassilis Mattress.
Enjoy 60 months interest-free financing on select Tempur-Pedics through Monday at Hassilis Mattress. Open 9 to 9. Find an employee-free showroom near you or shop online at Hassilis.com.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button.
One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
A little bit of a rain-snow mix today. Expect a little bit of that tonight as well, with a low of 33. Decreasing clouds tomorrow, maybe a peak of the sun, with a high of 43 degrees. 36 in Milwaukee at 12:48. All right, so you can't find a newspaper, a publication, an online service that isn't covering the eclipse in some way, shape, or form. Like, this is in my email inbox from our daughter's school district. There are stories about animals and their reaction to the eclipse, and it is coming. It'll be on Monday of next week. The path of totality, if you're along that path and you're a business owner, congrats to you, because you are likely cashing in, especially if you're a hotel operator. They're expecting this to be a $1.5 billion windfall for all the communities, towns, and cities along the path of totality. Well, that is not necessarily in the state of Wisconsin. If you want to be in among the 90% group, perhaps, but again, weather is going to be a factor in your enjoyment of the eclipse on Monday.
Well, and yeah, here's the thing. I mean, a lot of people right now are scrambling to change their plans due to the forecast. And you always have to know that's a possibility, that maybe weather won't let things work out. But people have been making plans for months with this. Severe thunderstorms possible in parts of the southern plains and lower Mississippi Valley, including in the path of totality. Which, by the way, you mentioned 100 miles wide. It's a path from Texas to Maine. But you've got cities like Indianapolis, Cleveland, Buffalo, New York, Dallas, all in that area. And storms could obscure the view for some, but are more likely to bring some risks for post-eclipse travelers, because even if everything works out okay, then it's like you have all of these cars, all of these people trying to get back to their destinations, and the storms may hamper their efforts.
Here is a twist to the story that I did not anticipate covering. With just 4 days to go until the eclipse, some of the country's prisoners are taking a stand to make sure they have a chance to see this marvel.
Suing the Department of Corrections for preventing them from watching the cosmic event, claiming their religious rights are being violated. One of the inmates saying, "I don't believe that just because I am incarcerated that I should be denied this opportunity." The Department of Corrections says the lockdown is intended to ensure the safety of inmates and staff.
Yeah, that's Andrea Fuji from ABC. So New York inmates are suing the Department of Corrections for preventing them from watching the eclipse. Well, maybe you shouldn't have robbed the gas station then.
No words for that one. It's like, what? I mean, you should have some rights, right? You should be able to eat and you should be able to stay clean. Should you be able to watch the eclipse? No.
Right. So to take you behind the scenes here a little bit, we've got a little feature here called ABC News Call, which covers all these stories worldwide throughout the day. There are so many different eclipse stories. Like, just take your pick.
One story I read was a flock of penguins that got their morning food, and then the eclipse happened, and they all got really worried that it was getting dark and they hadn't had their dinner yet, so they were pretty active.
Yeah, penguins are confused. We don't want that. What about the schools?
Some schools are canceling classes, while others in the eclipse's path plan some out-of-this-world lessons. In Detroit, students will release a weather balloon to document the event. Indiana's Butler University is recording the sun's corona using special telescopes. In upstate New York, elementary schools have created special curriculums to help kids understand the eclipse.
From our school system to confused penguins to inmates suing the Department of Corrections. There we go. There's our event.
Well, and you talk about animals, too. I had to go back because I remember reading and responding to one of our text messages from one of our listeners. So I wanted to go back and get this one to share with all of you. This listener went to an isolated area of Idaho for the 2017 eclipse and watched it from a dirt road with a few ranchers and their cattle. And the listener, who is in the 262 area code area, said the cows all freaked out. They laid down and moaned during the peak. And at first I was like, is this legit? Is this real? Did this really happen? But the text was so detailed. I mean, it was kind of fascinating. But yeah, the cows were a little concerned.
And who wouldn't be, right? It is coming. If you're looking to be in the Wisconsin area on the day of the eclipse, they say about 2 o'clock or so is going to be the peak for those looking to catch it. But again, you may have to drive a little bit to see it, given the weather conditions. So be mindful of that.
And this listener as well, who was talking about the cows, I thought was very smart, though, because this person went to an area that wasn't highly populated. So afterwards, he or she could just kind of go on the back roads and then go to the motel. It was kind of like a small town motel where the person stayed overnight until the traffic.